Today we're working with what I like to think of as page additions, bits of this and that, tags, envelopes, and stamp pieces that provide openings, secret doors, and places to peek into. The only limit to what you can accomplish with these techniques is your imagination. Let's go stretch our muses a bit and see what we can come up with. Tags are available in a lot of different sizes, and we're going to start with them today and talk about using the tag as a flap itself and cutting some openings in them. When I say using it as a flap itself, it means that the entire tag becomes the door, if you will, or the flap, and you move the whole piece at a time, versus cutting an opening in the tag and creating what looks like a door, or cutting a different kind of opening that actually looks nothing at all like a door. And we're going to look at all of that to start with. Let me turn this around. And we'll work on this page. I have this tag all ready to go, and I have put color on both sides, and obviously if this tag is going to flap, I need both sides to have color. Now I haven't decided what I'm going to put behind it, but I actually can wait and do that afterwards. I do want to show you how I put these on. I'm going to use a bone folder and a ruler, and I'm going to crease this. And you'll notice I'm going to go just over half an inch, and the reason I'm going to do that is because I'm going to use half inch score tape to put this in place. It's quick, it's easy, and it works super well for this kind of stuff. You've seen me use score tape in the score tape video. It's a product that I absolutely love. So now that I've got this crease in here, all I need to do now is fold it, and then when I put this on here, the door will go ahead and open, or the flap will open. So I have half inch score tape and some scissors. And I'm going to lay the tape right in here, snip it off, just burnish it on there for a second. Didn't burnish quite enough on that corner. Let me just get that peeled up and coming up. There we go. Score tape's on here. I'm going to decide where I want this. That looks pretty good right about there. And just like that, it's in place. This is perhaps one of the simplest kinds of flappy things that you can do. We're going to move on to something a little bit more complicated. We're going to cut some doors and some openings in just a moment. You can choose to make your doors or openings however you want. What I've done is the front of this tag has already been colored. It's ready to go from that perspective. And on the back, I've marked out where I want to cut my opening. And then once I'm done cutting that opening, I'll come back and I'll add color, because obviously the back of these doors will show when they open from the front. I do this, this is an Omnigrid ruler that you use with a rotary cutter. I find it very helpful for this kind of thing, and I use this all of the time, even though I don't work with fabric a whole lot anymore. And I'm going to use a utility knife. I find that this is easier for me to work with. You can use whatever works for you. Just going to come along the line, and there's part of my cut. So I've got one on the top and one on the bottom, and now I'm going to cut the opening that will allow these doors to flap open. When you do this, you want to be certain that you don't extend your cut, and I need to mark this with a pencil. I can't quite see my end line. You want to be certain that you don't cut down into the bottom and the top here where your doors are not, or you're going to end up with a gap that you might end up either having to repair or saying, okay, well, this one doesn't work, so I'm going to just toss it. So again, I'm going to be really careful and just be certain that I start right where that opening is and very carefully cut. So now I have, these are kind of, they remind me of tavern style doors. And again, what I can do is grab my bone folder, line this up, and this time I will put a crease on both sides so that these doors have a place to flap open. And I'm not going to do both of them, you don't need to see that, but you can see by scoring that, I get that bend to start, and I get my door to open a lot more gracefully than if I just tried to fold that by hand. Let me show you now what I do once I have a door set to go, or rather a tag set to go, and this one is earmarked to sit on this page about here. And it's going to open, and it's all ready to go. So what I'm going to do is show you now. When I design these openings, I try to bear in mind the size of the score tape that I have on hand. But having said that, while one strip of half inch fit in beautifully here, this is a little bit narrower. It's a little bit too wide to just use quarter inch. So what I did, and I think you can probably see the shininess here, this is a piece of score tape that I already adhered and pulled the backing tape off of, and then I put another one on right here so that I have a piece of tape that's wide enough and it will overlap a little bit, and that's just fine. So now what I need to do is cut a piece to go here, and then we'll put this in place. What I don't want to do is have adhesive cover this opening, so I'm trying to cut my piece big enough to cover the exposed area, but not so much that the hole in the tag would have adhesive showing over it. So I've got my tape all on, and now what I'm going to do is just peel off the backing. And the score tape just makes this so simple, far easier than working with liquid glue or a glue stick. And you all know that I'm a giant fan of the Aileen's Super Thick Designer Tacky Glue, but score tape changed my life. I love this stuff. Okay, so my tape is all in place, and once this stuff is down, you get one shot. So be certain that you know where you want it to go and that you're straight, and then just gently apply it, making certain that you're where you want to be. Give it a push, and it's in place. And now I have this cool door that I can stamp on the front of. I can do all kinds of fun things around here. I can even stamp on the back of this door if I want, and then of course there'll be whatever I decide to put in here. Let me show you how creative you can get with something as simple as an envelope. These are made by Meyer Rhode, and they come packaged two each of 5 styles for a total of 10. And you can see that there's different flaps on them, there's different shapes, and they measure anywhere from 3x4 to 4x5.5. I like envelopes. You can store little things in here, you can put hidden messages or little secrets in there. And rather than leave this plain, I came in and I used 2 stamps from the Dilusions How Does Your Garden Grow set, and I randomly stamped them on the front of the envelope and on the flap. Coloring these is really easy. I have Dilusions and I have Color Wash in the Tim Holtz water brushes, and I'm just going to come in and blend some colors on here till I get a look that kind of works with this page. It's really that simple. It's just a 2-minute project to get all of these done. I do want to dry this. And then I'm just going to outline the petals with a metallic jelly roll pen to sort of get this other fun look that I like a lot. If it glitters, I'm loving it. All right, that's good. And you can see that all I did was just go ahead and outline these. It's very quick, very easy. Really, it's just following the lines that you already stamped. Let me get this little edge right here, and we'll be ready to move on. I'm going to use this envelope not just for storage. I'm also going to use it, and I'm just going to hit this with the heat gun while I talk. I'm also going to use it as the body for what essentially becomes a paper doll. Let me turn this so it's oriented correctly on the page. I have previously cut out, or stamped, painted, and cut out a bunch of different component pieces. And what I have plans to do is lay them all on here so that it forms this really fun doll. And the page won't be complete once she's set. It will be a matter of perhaps coming in and writing on it, or who knows, adding other bits until I'm satisfied with it. But all these disparate elements go together to make this really cool image. Now you'll notice that on the back of these, guess what, is score tape, so that when I'm ready and I'm satisfied, and I'm not going to do this on camera because I'm liable to make a mess of it, but once I'm satisfied with the alignment, I'll go ahead and put all these pieces in place, then I'll come back and I'll run lengths of score tape along the back, pull off the paper, stick it in place, and it's that simple. Things like envelopes make great little additions to your pages, great little storage areas, and great little fun things. Our final page addition for today involves using a rubber stamped image. This is called Welcome Door. It's from Stampoutique Originals. I love this door. What I did was stamped it with Stays On ink on a piece of 90-pound watercolor paper. And what I'm envisioning is this door opening and closing, but there are hinges here and they're not quite long enough to accomplish what I want to. So all I did was take a Pitt pen, extend these hinges a little bit, and you just kind of make them look like the rest of the hinge on here in that sort of grungy style. And you just play a little bit until you have a hinge that looks just like it did if it had been stamped with the original stamp. And what I did with this one was, here's my welcome door, and I went ahead and I added color using the water brushes and the dilutions and all of those fun things. And I even went so far as to stamp on the back because I kind of liked this look. Here are the hinges that I extended beyond what the original stamped image was, and I've got score tape on here. So all I'm going to do is peel the backing paper, if I can get my thumbnail under there, peel the backing paper off of the score tape. Now in this case, I already have what I want under the door stamped on the page, so I have to be careful when I line this up that I line it up about in the place where it would be if the door opened. And I'm just going to kind of take a peek under there, and that looks pretty good. Now because there's so little score tape on those hinges, it does allow me a little bit of freedom to make a mistake if it comes to that, and I probably could lift this up, but I want to be certain that this is sort of square on the page. And then I'm just going to press those hinges in place, and again, how can you not love score tape? The door opens, it reveals our little figure underneath, and of course it reveals what we stamped on the back of the door. I hope you've enjoyed all of these fun page additions that we've kind of played with today, and most of all, I hope you make art and have fun.